Well, we know that infertility affects about 7.3 million couples in the United States. About half of those couples have factors involving the woman, either alone or in combination with male factors, and about half those couples have problems involving the man, again alone or in combination with female factors. So really, when you break it down, about half of the couples we see have abnormalities in sperm production or sperm function. If a guy knows that he's got an issue, for example, if he has a testicle that's enlarging, which may indicate a testicular tumor, if he's got a swelling in the scrotum that may indicate a dilated vein called a varicocele, then it's reasonable for him to go directly to a urologist. If he really doesn't have any of those things and he and his partner are just having trouble conceiving, they really should come to a fertility specialist first, because we can coordinate the entire evaluation. Most male factor issues don't require surgical intervention or surgical correction. If we believe that there's a problem that the semen analysis reveals, then we may very well suggest that they go see a urologist, and we would refer them to a urologist who has a lot of experience in infertility. The first thing we do, it's just like evaluating a female. We take a history. So we find out, has he caused any pregnancies in the past? How long did it take to produce a pregnancy? Has he had any medical illnesses of any significance? Has he had any operations, especially scrotal operations? A vasectomy reversal, repair of a varicocele, even hernia repair or other types of scrotal surgery? Has he had any sexually transmitted diseases? Does he take any medications that may adversely affect sperm production, sperm function, or even sexual performance? A lot of high blood pressure medicine, for example, can affect those things. Antidepressants can certainly affect those things. Caffeine, cigarette smoking, alcohol to excess, illicit drugs, all of those can adversely affect sperm production or sperm function.